I'm going to show you an application of logarithms that comes from astronomy. There's an equation in astronomy relating the brightness of stars and their distance, and that's what this equation will happen to be. Here's what the equation happens to look like. I need to define what these different variables in here are. Over on the left here, this may not look like it, but it's an uppercase M, and it's something called the absolute magnitude of the star. We'll be talking about stars here in all of this. There's a lowercase m in the equation. M is something called the apparent magnitude. I'll talk a little bit more about these soon. And then there's a third variable in here, a d. D is the distance to the star measured in light years. A light year is a unit of distance. It's the distance that light travels in one year. And it happens to be a convenient unit of distance in astronomy because the nearest star to us other than our sun is so far away that it takes light more than 4 years to reach us from that star. So that makes a light year a convenient distance. What these other things mean, magnitude has to do with how bright a star appears. And the lowercase m, this one here, is just how bright it looks to us here on Earth. Well, you might imagine that stars are going to get dimmer with distance, and that is the case. It's hard to compare stars directly when they get dimmer with distance. So astronomers figured out a way to take distance out of it, and this equation happens to be the result. The absolute magnitude, the uppercase m here, is how bright a star would be if it was at a standard distance. So this equation effectively takes the distance out of the relation. I'll show you just one example of actually solving this for an absolute magnitude. Let's suppose a star has an apparent magnitude of 6.3, and this star happens to be 215 light years away, so its distance is 215. And I'm not writing down the units here, it'll just be a little easier to deal with if I don't do that. Well, we can calculate the absolute magnitude in that case. The absolute magnitude is going to equal this equation up at the top here. I just plug the numbers into. So I put in the 6.3 minus 5, this is multiplication here, it's times the log of the distance divided by 32.6. Oops, I forgot to put in the distance. So we'll just do that here. 6.3 minus 5 times the log of 215 over 32.6. Because of the way this is written, it's understood that this is a log base 10. You may have learned in your class that if a logarithm doesn't have a base explicitly written on it, then it's base 10, although there's another kind of log that maybe you've been introduced to that is just abbreviated ln. That particular kind of log has a different base. I'm not going to go into that. And this is something you can do on your calculator. If you've got a TI-30X2 calculator, the keystrokes on this would just be, I'll write them down over here, you would just go 6.3, hit the minus button, 5, hit the multiplication button, hit the log button, and when you hit the log button on there, it gives you a parentheses, so a left parentheses, and so you'd go 215, then hit the divided by button, 32.6, hit the right parentheses button, and then hit equal. And when you do that, you'll get the result of this calculation. I would get 2.2, so the absolute magnitude of that star happens to be 2.2. That's just plugging and chugging on a formula. I want to show you an example of using this equation to solve for the distance. Because of the way stars fall into categories and have predictable behavior under some circumstances, it's possible to determine the absolute magnitude without knowing the distance to the star. And if that's the case, then you can actually calculate for the distance. And so I'm going to go back to our equation that we have up here at the top in the box. I'll circle it again and solve that for the distance. So here's how I'll do it. Okay, first thing I'll do is subtract the lowercase m from each side, and I have to be careful to not confuse upper and lowercase. And so that will equal negative 5 times the log of d over 32.6. I'll divide both sides by negative 5 next. So that will give me m minus little m over negative 5 is going to equal the log of d over 32.6. Dividing by a negative will actually reverse the order up there, or if you can imagine multiplying top and bottom by negative 1 if you want. But this left-hand side can change into little m minus capital M over 5 is equal to the log of d over 32.6. Now, I can't multiply that 32.6 out from underneath because it's in the logarithm, and the logarithm is a function of what's inside, so it doesn't work quite that way. If you remember the definition of a logarithm, it is the exponent you put on the base. In this case, the base is 10. The logarithm is the exponent you put on the base to get what's inside. And so this little m minus capital M over 5 is the exponent on a 10. If I put that on a 10 as an exponent, it's going to be a little messy looking for an exponent, but that will equal the d, that's a d, over 32.6. Now I can multiply out from underneath by that 32.6, and I would get 32.6 times 10 with an exponent on it of little m minus capital M over 5 is equal to d. And so this is a way that we can actually determine the distance to a star.